Thank you so much for everyone come to this session. And 非常感谢大家在饥肠辘辘的中午来听这个 session， 然后看到很多熟悉的面孔。如果我记得没有错的话，应该是一个英文的 session。 If I recall correctly, this should be an English session. And so I'm Chinese, and I actually I submit two topics. One is Chinese, and the other is English. But looks the Chinese have a higher threshold for the topics. So I only got this selected. And I saw there is some. Is there anyone who can't learn in Chinese? So I just asked the staff whether this is a English or Chinese session. And I haven't got the final notification, so I will use English for the topics. And if anyone have any questions, you can ask me in English. In Chinese. Yeah, that both are okay. And our topic is from secure container to secure service. And I'm Xu Wang from Ant Financial, and here's my colleague, Fupan. He's also here. And also, let's recall to the last year in Seattle, we have another session for about the Kata and gVisor to a comparison. And you know, currently my boss is sitting there, and he worked for gVisor previously. So I won't try to do the comparison again. And in last year, we summarized the progress of Kata containers and also talked about the overhead and the other issues. And this time we will do some update for that. And also we predict the secure containers going to be in production in this year. And now half a year passed, and at least we have go into production, and now we join the on financial, and there is last year we have another topics about the Kubernetes and Kubernetes and Kata containers. In this topic we talk about use the runtime class and to configure the Kata containers with Kubernetes with the Shim V2 to work together. So I think if you need some background or need some background knowledges to do a hand-on or to try the Kata containers, you may reference the video for that. And that's also in English, and you know my English is, so you have to learn the English for that. And yes. I want to know how many people here learned the keynote this morning for the Linux towers. Nobody. You guys got up so late. And yes, this is back to 2015 in Seattle, and at that keynote it's very similar, and there is interview with towers, and the towers talk about the security of Linux and of containers. And he said the real solution to security is have multiple layers, that to do another isolation layer for that. That's what Kata containers do. This is our background, and for the Linux containers themselves, use the namespace and other C groups and C comp to do the container isolations for the applications. But you know, it's really hard for that because there is only one Linux kernel, and once you do an exploit, you compromise the the host kernel, then you got all the world. But for Kata Containers or gVisor, we have an actual isolation layer, and we have a secure sandbox, and put the application process in the sandbox, and use a independent kernel inside for the resource and security isolations. And yesterday I heard of that from the book. I know some or Intel colleagues put the Android in the Kata containers, and they played Angry Bird with that. And I think that's pretty interesting. And also that's what we talk about, that is the Kata containers do the things to run the native Linux or similar applications inside the Kata containers, and have the same compatibility, even better compatibility with the native Linux containers. Let me just do a brief history of the Kata containers, and back to four years ago, and in May 2015, and our team and the Intel team announced Clear Containers and RunV separately, and we are two independent projects, but we, when the times go to 2017, we merged the two projects into Kata Containers and host it in another foundation, and announced the 1.0 in May 2018. That's the time the gVisor announced. so many people left. They must hate my speak. And in the April 2019, Kata Containers confirmed in the bar meeting of that foundation, and also we have the 1.7 in May, and we're going to have the 1.8 soon, and that's the brief history. Let me talk about some progress. You know, at the time last year we have the 1.4, and in the January we have 1.5, and the 1.5 we have the SHIMB2 support, and I think that's one of the most important. Important progress of Kata containers, and also for the Kubernetes community. Actually, that's interface firstly defined for not only Kata containers but also for gVisor, and that means the containerd of the Kubernetes. The containerd of the Kubernetes won't treat the container itself as a process, they can use some secure sandbox to support about that. So they hide the detail of how you implement the container itself with the Shim API, and behind the Shim API, you can do some magic for your sandbox technologies, and the container will just to launch the containers and monitor the containers through this API, and won't use the PID to access the process, won't kill it or do any other things. So you don't need to have a shim for each process, each containers here. And you know, the sandbox itself is a process. It need a shim, and also other containers all need shims. So in the previous architecture, we need about 2n plus 2 shim process for the for run the secure sandbox. That's a big overhead for the systems. But in this year, when we have the shim v2, we don't need to have so many shims for that. We only have one shim v2 process, and this is this cut down the big overhead for the whole architectures, and you don't need to schedule so many processes for that. And this introduced some new problem, new issues, and because there is a long-lived process at the same life cycle with this one, so we have to enhance the security level for this process. So this is part of our current job. And also, in the by the end of last year, the AWS announced the firecrackers. You know this, and maybe that's a very important progress in the VMM area. And the Kata support the firecracker at once. And in the 1.5, we have the firecracker support. And also. Right now, the firecracker, because the limitation of firecracker itself, we have the some limitation for the usage of the firecrackers. But for some scenarios, you can accept the restrictions. You can use the firecracker for less overhead for that, and. Yes, this is another part because of we have the runtime class in the upstream Kubernetes, so we can run not only the in the single node, we can run not only the run C container but also Kata containers. We can also use the different configuration for that. We can run the Cumul virtual machine for the Kata containers. Also, we can run the firecracker virtual machine for the Kata containers. All these three types of the shape of the containers we can run on a single pod and use the runtime class of the Kubernetes. Yeah, that's give more flexible to the flexibility to the users, and also in last month in the 1.7 release, we have the virtio-fs experimental support here. And you know, in the last year, we do some benchmarks on the IO side, and one slide of it is about the file system benchmarks. That's it's really a hard time for me to do that presentation that because the file system part is really a pain point for the secure container side, and that's really many problem of the 9P support, and not only the performance but also the POSIX compatibility for that. But after that, we have a new file system sharing method in the Kata. In Kata containers or in the virtualization world, that's the virtio-fs. The virtio-fs is originally implemented by Red Hat and by Stephen, and we use the fields as a fields front end in the guest kernel and to provide the POSIX compatible interface to the application. You know, once you have the fields, you have almost a full POSIX compatibility here. And the different things is the backend is use the variant of the virtio to implement it in the guest, and we also use the vhost user. So we can implement virtio-fsd in the user space of the host to provide the file system backend for the guest application. If you attend the the last session of the gVisor, you know, for the gVisor, they use a separate process called Gopher to provide the file system things. They implement the IP protocol. And also here, we use the vHouse user to provide another process to provide the file system access through the user space of the host. So the same thing is once you have a independent process here, you have the you may try to enhance security for just for this independent process that make life much easier. And also we have a vHouse user and the DAX support. You know the DAX is a feature of the file systems, and that's for the AEP device, or say the something like the NVDIMM. And here, if you know the NVDIMM itself by some means that's memory. So that's access is much faster than the file disk. So for access to the things on the NVDIMM on the memory, we don't need to load it into memory as a page cache first. So we don't need to use the page cache in the guest. Actually, we may use some virtual NVDIMM things outside the VMM on the host. So if the file system is all the same in the host, and we don't need to allocate the page cache for the guest applications for each containers. They all may share the guest the page cache on the host. So this not only accelerate the access of the devices, but also they save the memories. And that's the whole architecture. It's fully designed for the virtualization case scenarios, and not like the 9P or something NFS that's for the networking access. So this employ the new technologies such as DAX or vHouse users for the virtual machines, and for the you can use it in the local host. And last month, we have some discussion with the Red Hat developers. They taught us the things like migration or something similar is also on their roadmaps, and maybe they will kick off the develop of the migration things by the end of this year. And also for the things you must care about the performance. If you have used the 9P, you know the you will care about the performance of virtio-fs as well, and sorry, I thought I added some numbers here, but I forgot it. I merged the slide. Okay, I will talk the numbers to you, and for the for some benchmarks, we use FIO with the no cache version of the a DAX enabled version of the vHouse user and the 9P no cache or mmap cache. We can monitor from the 70% to 90% performance boost compared to 9P FS. And but based on the statement from the Red Hat developers, they think they are several times performance better than the 9PFS. I think there are different test cases, but one thing we can confirm is the performance of the virtio-fs is much better than the 9PFS. And I think that's about at least 80% of the EXE4 system on the local host. Yeah, that's the performance of the warehouse vertical FS. So in the past half an year, we have some progress in better integration with Kubernetes and less memory overhead. Also, we have the improvements on the file system sharing. You know, right now in the 1.7, the vertical FS support is still in the experimental stage. That's because the kernel patch is not landed in the kernel, and we back and Red Hat developers and us collaborate on backport them into the 4.19 kernel for the long term kernel, and there are also some patch on the cumul 4.0, and later that will all be merged into kernel and the cumul upstream, and also we will turn the vertical FS apart from the experimental to the stable. You know, the security is an end-to-end issue, you know. It's not only, you can not only do the single host secure as hardened for the whole systems. We need a full secured service in the financial scenarios. Right now we have joined the Ant Financial. We do some things about the so-called the financial grade infrastructures, and the one trend in the application, you know, there have many people mentioned that in both this conference and the conference last month in Barcelona, the service mesh. Yeah, I try to separate the many functionalities that's integrated into the service itself, separate them into sidecars to do the things like service discoveries and load balancing and traffic routing and blah blah blah. And this turned to a question. The sidecar itself is part of the user container or a part of the infrastructures. For us, we are the infrastructure team, and we think that's for our infrastructure developers should provide a concrete base for the services and make the service developers or the application developers focus on their business logic, and they don't need to care the detail of the sidecars, and we should provide the sidecars as well. And include the security and other things inside it. And so the first step is to integrate the service mesh and the Kata containers together. And this is in this picture we do some not only the application with the inside the guest and but also the sidecars. And one thing we want to confirm is only when the sidecars move to the Kata containers and not in the Linux containers, that they can work together with the just like the in the native Linux containers. And also, we will try to do a demonstration with the Istio and some Cicado and other components that they can work together, and later we will introduce some improvement or some customization for the financial environments in our financial. And here we have two simple demo to show how we can integrate the service mesh part together with the Kata containers. And these two cases, you can simply find them in the Istio website. And
for the time, we can. I think we can just. Just use one video for that. We can. It's very easy to. Here is a simple illustration for that.
And this is that's the same as the Istio's tutorials. You can just apply a policy for that to enable the MTLS for the data plane. And when we have the policy live, and we can find the legacy without the sidecars cannot communicate with others, but the other sidecars they work well with the MTLS environment. And the only difference from the official issue tutorials cases are in our environment here is the Kata containers. So this shows the availability for the Kata containers and the service mesh themselves. And also we have some other illustrations for the RBAC, the RBAC authentication part. I think the time, and I will show some keep all the demos video. We will upload them later, and you can find them, and you can also try this with the service mesh with the Kata containers. They all works well, and also for our team, when we join the Ant Financial, the part is we try to support the SofaMesh. The scalable infrastructure in the for our financial environment, and part of this is a product have a very long history, and the part of it is as based on the ISOA or the original ideas, and right now it have upgrade to the SofaMesh, and that's an customized version for the you can think that that's a customized version for the Istio, and we have a daemon called SofaMotion, and that's at the same position with the Envoy and to do the data plane things, and also we have some extension for the architectures, and for the Istio, and we use SDS for the sidecars to deliver the certifications and to build the data plane trusted connection layer, and for SofaMesh we also have extend the SDS for a new method to deliver more trusted identity and to support the architectures, and that's the right now currently we have support the. We have make the Kata works with Istio and also SofaMesh, and SofaMesh will have more update in the shortly and have the new version for that. And in the future, we will do some work on the mesh sidecar optimization for the Kata context. Selenium part and to do the some VPF support and to accelerate the data plane for the Kata scenarios and also have also do the interoperabilities with non-Kata containers to make the make them have the better data planes for that. Also, we will do something about the resource isolation between the mesh sidecars and other user containers. You know, when you write a pod spec, you will apply resources for your containers. And right now for Kata containers, we do the resource restrictions for the whole sandbox itself. But in the future, we want to make it when you try to assign some resource, the resource is for your user containers, not for the guest kernels and for the sidecars for all the infra part. That's not the user part. That's some of the future works, and that's all. Any questions? Huh? Okay. 你的问题是不是可以用自己的 kernel 是吗？
对，大概是这样，
就是说正常的说呢， 原则上说是可以的， 但是呢， 实际上取决于你用什么样的 kernel。 就是这还依赖到就是比如说我们依赖的 kernel feature， 然后你有没有等等。正常的讲，我们应该说是因为现在的 kernel 用的是upstream 用的是 4.19 的 kernel， 然后 4.19 LTS 的 kernel， 然后如果说你的版本差的不是很多的话，应该说支持你的 kernel 问题不是很大。如果版本差的很多的话，就可能需要这个很多的 work 去。 上面去做，那就是实际上你就是现在看着里面自带的那个kernel是维护的很好的，是吧？会一直去更新啊？是的，我们的 kernel 是会一直去，就是我们会维护我们自己的 kernel configuration， 同时会build一个 by default 的 kernel 给你。然后这个 kernel 一般情况下我们会跟住这个当前的 LTS 的版本，然后我们本身会维护两个 stable 的 release， 都是会跟住当时的就 release 时候的一个这个 LTS 的 kernel。 然后会跟着它来做更新，比如这次那个 CVE 之后，我们就是响应那个 CVE， 我们也会直接去推一个新的这个版本的 kernel 上来，大概是这样。但是我们自己会维护一个很小的一个这个 off tree 的这个 patch set， 因为这个 off tree 的 patch 本身是有比较大的这个维护负担的，就如果没有特殊的必要性的话，我们就不会加这个 off tree 的 patch。
就是说，不是很建议自己去做这个事儿，是吧？这个
depends on you， 就是你自己的这个需求在哪儿。就是如果你很需要你的 kernel， 没有你的 kernel， 你不工作的话，那还是可以用你的 kernel， 因为我们 configuration 也在，所以你可以直接 reference 我们的 configuration。 怎么说呢？就是说，如果你做这个 微服务的这件事情，其实本质上说。 你把它打成了容器，一个潜台词就是，其实你不是特别 care 这个 kernel 的问题，要 portable 嘛。但是事实上就是，如果你真的去 care 这件事情的话，那你可以自己做。好，谢谢。哎，你好，我问一下，那个
gVisor 跟 Kata， 其实他们那个在你看来有什么样的区别？具体的应用场景啊之类的。那如果是作为一个用户，我该怎么选这个 Kata 或者？
几外的去应用在我的产品上面，能说一下你来自哪儿吗？我来自于互联网公司。能简单介绍一句吗？就是因为大家也想知道。
对，我是来自于那个一家互联网金融公司，所以可能会对这种也比较关心。
我们也是，同行。这个问题 case by case 的说，就是。 就是说，不同的人会有这个不同的选择。就是说，如果说你觉得你 我的建议是因为我们目前的 Kata Containers 还是一个比较 community 的一个项目，就是说参与者也比较多一些，然后如果你有能力自己做一切，那你的选择就你选择也是什么都可以，然后但是如果你觉得你的能力并不足以说，比如说你觉得 gVisor 有问题，你可不可以处理，如果出现了 compatible 的问题，你可不可以修掉它，然后如果说有什么 leakage 什么，你可不可以处理掉，如果你不可以的话，你最好跟着社区走，是吧？
我问一个问题啊，就是那个刚才看你的那个 PPT 的时候，有一个没看明白的，就是你的那个就是用户容器是吧 ？User container， 还有你的系统组件，你是全部都跑在 Kata 上的吗？还是只把系统组件跑在 Kata 上面？
你指什么？
就是你有一页那个 presentation 上面划分了那个 user。哦，再往上，哎，就这儿。
我们是都要放到 Kata 里面的。
就你的那个 business logic。
对，我们最主要的就是把 business logic 要放进来。sidecar 只是为了和它一起工作，所以必须得放进来。
sidecar 也要放在 Kata 里面吗？
对，是因为他们为了要一起工作，他们会在同一个 domain 里边。但是最主要的是要把这个 user container 放进来。
你。其实在我看来 sidecar 其实可以不放在那个Kata 里面吧，就是只是保一你的 business logic 这部分可能放进去。
这取决于怎么定义 sidecar 的功能呢，然后就是我们 sidecar 的功能定义是去会直接去做这个用户 container 的这个 application 的这个流量转发这样的工作的。所以它必须要在它在里面去接触到它的流量，然后做处理会更加灵活，就是会有更强的这个处理的能力。然后因为在里面的时候，他们是相当于是同一个 network namespace 里面的。如果你把它拉出来的话，它就到不同的 network namespace， 然后你就把流量混在一起了。
你现在是把那个 business logic 和你的 sidecar 都放在同一个 pod 里面的吗？
对呀。
哎，然后再问一个，就是那个你们现在是用那个 virtio-fs 情况怎么样？
我刚才已经就是大概说了一下了，就是说 virtio-fs 第一就是它的这个 POSIX 兼容性肯定是远比这个 9P 要强的，至少在 Linux 上肯定是这样的。然后第二呢，就是说在 performance 方面呢是比 9P 是有很大的提升的。然后我刚才说，就是说在我们测试到的 case 里边，大家看到会有70%-90%的性能提升。Red Hat 的这个测试里面给出了，我忘了是4倍还是8倍这样的提升了。数太高的时候我们不太信了，会做一些单独立的测试，就是我们觉得 workload 大概是这样的一个测试。然后所以我觉得就是，从这个，如果你必须要用这个 filesystem sharing 的话，virtio-fs 应该是一个就是一个更好的选择。当然，如果这个你问我，我在生产环境中是怎么样子的话，这个不太好说。磁盘 O 的隔离性方面是这样的，就是说，因为就是说，如果你做大 large scale 的话，其实你的 IO 很大程度上说其实都是网络 IO， 对吧？就是如果你是，我是说，就是说，如果你做 large scale 系统的话，基本上你不太用 local 的存储。然后，但是如果说你要非要说我用 local 存储能不能限制的话，就是说。原则上说作为虚拟机实际上是可以限制的，但是你很难对磁盘做特别硬的限制，因为 local disk 很慢，你如果对它做硬限制的话，你会性能很难接受。软限制的话，其实我觉得就大家会做一些吧，会做一些，
就是比如说那个，比如说我用 overlay 的那个容器嘛，然后用 9P 挂进去的话，然后其实那个 overlay 本身如果本地的话，我用很快的那个硬件磁盘，那速度还是可以的，但是我挂到 9P 以后，因为它不是那个类似于那个 Linux 里面的那个 block 层嘛，是吧？所以不能精确的给它做一些那个 C group。
叫 quota 是吗？
不是 quota， 是那个 C group 里面的限速的那种功能。quota 的话，因为它那个像 project quota 就可以给它限速。
限速 filesystem sharing 方式的限速确实是会比较难，不是 block device 会容易一些，在 block layer 可能会容易一些。但是你现在要想做的是，我想你可能想做的是 per container 的限速是吧？
啊，对对对对，
这个可能确实是对于 IT 来说可能确实有点问题。
这方面就社区的这个计划会不会有这方面有一些改善？
我觉得不会，不会有更多的这个 effort 搁到 9pfs 上，都会是走到 virtio-fs 上面。
你说 virtio-fs 这方面会有一些改进是吗？
那我目前没看到就是这方面的东西在里面，就是数据在里面，就大家没有，就大家还没有 focus 在这个上面。但是我觉得是可以做的，然后，但是场景其实比较复杂，因为它走了好几条不同的路。但是想做，我觉得如果你有强烈的需求，怎么都是可以做的。
就是这个需求，就是说我在一个节点里面，可能部署很多个实例嘛，那就是说。为了隔离他们的相互影响，可能比如说我的
这个这个 case 我知道，对，就是说简单的说就是你 put 多少 effort 在上面，就是你花多少资源在上面去，我要解决这个做这个隔离的问题，然后最后你可以。
目前社区是
目前对，目前是这样的，就是目前我们没有这方面的这个东西在我们的 roadmap 上面，但是其实并不妨碍你在社区里面去提这个 issue。然后就是说因为社区这件事情就是所有的事情开发啊什么都是 open 的，所以如果你有这个 issue 提上来，然后大家觉得这个 valid 就会把它反过来就会把它加进去了。
喂，你好，我想那个更深入一下问一下刚才那哥们儿问的那个问题，就是对比这个gVisor 和这个和 Kata 的，就是假如说我们有能力维护这个事情，就是从头做，那这个他们的这个方案的优劣是什么？特别是从架构层面来讲，就是说不说具体的细节，因为有很多事情你能实现，我也能实现。
这个问题啊，这个问题其实比较难，不太适合像我。你看你前面有一个人，你但是你跟他聊就可以了。
啊，那。
因为现在蚂蚁金服反正现在也是有 gVisor， 然后也有 Kata Container， 其实就是说我们也在内部在讨论很多这个问题，因为我之前做 gVisor 的，然后徐总他们是做 Kata 的，然后这个东西呢本质上就是说不同的应用场景啊，然后两个架构最大区别，你这里没放那个图，就是说资源边界和安全边界画在哪的问题，就是说你如果说安全边界画在 KVM 那层，然后资源边界在上面，对吧？这就是 Kata Container，资源边界如果在下面，安全边界在上面，在内核那层。因为 gVisor 最大的区别就是说它内核换掉了，不是 Linux， 是一个安全内核，是一个 Go 重新写的安全内核。但是缺点也很明显，对吧？就是说特别开源版的，就是 performance， 然后再加上它的那个compatibility， 就是说是不是能够做的比 Linux 还像 Linux， 这个其实是个伪命题了啊。所以说你看什么的 user case。然后比较适合的 user case 像 gVisor 那种 case， 其实就是说做Solace 做 fast 啊，那是非常非常适合的，因为它特别小，然后启动速度实际上比 Kata 还是要快一点的，对吧？特别在 CMV2 以后会好一点，但是本质上就是说 gVisor 的那个optimization 的 goal 就是那个 Kata container 呢，因为它本质上还是一个 VM 嘛，就是说我们做了很多 effort 在这个上面，但是它天生俱来的就是它是 Linux啊，没有人能比它更像 Linux 了，对吧？所以说它的 compatibility， 你的 container 基本上可以 claim， 就是说你可以 moving ready， 你就直接弄进去就完了，这是第一步。然后那之后的事情呢，实际上你可以叫个 infra， 你可以继续往下做。刚才还有一个同学提了那个，就是说 kernel 是不是可以改，或者说可以定制吧，是吧？
啊，对，
就可以自己去做定制。这实际上就是说要讨论一个问题，就是 kernel 到底是不是 infra 一部分，是 user provided 还是说我的 infra 的，对吧？所以说那回过头来说这个东西，我觉得两种 solution 其实都存在，就包括 run C 还有包括其他很多的option 都存在，但是现在我只能说不是你二选一的时候， 就是你要看你的 case 什么，就是 case by case。就是我蚂蚁现在其实也有这两种 case。
你好，我来问两个简单问题吧。就是一个问题，就是我们这个 Kata 也好 ，gVisor 也好，现在已经在蚂蚁金服在生产环境在用了吗？然后第二个问题是，刚才您也提到那个 Kata 和基于 RunC 的一个那个 benchmark， 这个 benchmark 你能给我们简单的讲一下吗？有没有一个数据？
等一下，等一下，两个问题分别来回答。第二个问题我没听清，第一个问题我先回答，就是说，目前我们用了多少规模这个事情呢？是一个我需要这个 confirm 之后才能确定可不可以说的一个问题。所以我现在呢，我现在呢不能说，但是我可以很明确的告诉你，就是不仅是我们蚂蚁金服，而且包括阿里云，在未来的系统里面，你都可以感受到 Kata 给你提供的服务。然后第二个问题是什么？
这个问题就是刚才你也提到那个 benchmark， 就是 Kata 和就 RunV 和 RunC 的那个一个。
我在去年的时候，去年末的那个 KubeCon 上面，就是北美的 KubeCon 上面，给了一个就是很多就是很长那个 topic 去做这个对比，所以你直接可以翻，就我这次 reference 了那个类似的那个 topic， 然后那个是整个的全程的 video 都在里面，然后呢是包括了。做了 CPU 的、内存的、IO 的，然后包括不同的环境下，就是 CPU 是不是在有 nested virtualization 的情况下，然后以及一些这个其他的一些实际的 case， 比如说 Redis 的 case， 然后做 TensorFlow 的 case， 然后等等这些的，就是不同的 case， 然后它的性能的对比，大概是有这样做了这样的一个 comparison， 所以那个你可以 reference 一下那个 topic 讲了两次，然后有。第二次有一个更新，第二次就是那个北美的 KubeCon， 就是去年的那个 Seattle 的那个。
好的，谢谢。
Kata Container 和 gVisor 你们有没有做过详细的一个性能损耗的一个测试？
我刚才给的那个里边实际上包括了就是 overhead， 包括那个 memory CPU 以及就是IO 还有甚至 boot time 所有的这些都做过，然后呢但是测试呢不是说那个就是 daily test， 所以呢当那个数据呢我不能说现在还是在的，然后大概的给一个感觉就是这样的，刚才我说了就是和这个那个 virtio-fs 这边的一个 update， 就是和当前的这个 host 的比起来的话 ，host 上面的这个磁盘比起来的话，性能大概是80%。然后那个如果是其他的那些方面的话，大概是 CPU 没什么问题，大家都知道虚拟化 CPU 没有任何问题。然后网络这边的话，如果就看你用的 stack， 然后基本上你可以 enable 所有的那些就是原来给那个 VM 做的那些。就是网络的加速啊，包括 vhost user 这些 dptk 啊这些东西都可以用，然后呢这个网络，然后这两个都比较好办，然后比较大的是 memory 的 consumption， 然后 memory consumption 呢如果是 qmil 的话应该是这个做过合适的这个 configuration 之后应该是几十兆的一个水平，每个 token 的，然后 firecracker 会更小， firecracker 可能大概十几兆的大概一个水平，然后 inside container 的话我们有一个 kernel 嘛，然后这个 kernel 本身的这个 text 的段就是这个固定的这段呢，应该说是因为我们可以用很多 copy and write 的手段去干掉它，就是它实际上它是没有额外的这个 memory 开销的，但是它本身会 allocate 一些 memory 去管理 gas 的嘛，这部分当然如果你这个进程跑在 host 上面它也要有这样一部分开销。然后呢我们的 guest agent 呢，然后目前看呢大概会引入十兆左右的开销，然后呢但是我们现在正在努力去把它减到一兆以下，总的来说大概就是这样吧。
好，谢谢。我想问一个问题啊，就是
就是卡塔在跑在什么样的 Linux 版本上比较合适，什么样的内核这样子？
原则上说我们跑容器的嘛，不太挑这个宿主系统。实际上呢，应该说还是 kernel 会新一点会比较好，因为 kernel 新一点的话会方便你去跑一些这个比较新的 kernel feature 来帮你去减掉一些 不必要的开销。比如说这些这个 DEX 的支持啊，然后 VSOC 的支持啊， VSOC 应该是 DEX 支持要版本， DEX 是不是只要 DEX 支持要哪个版本？已经支持了，但是原来最早要哪个版本？然后 VSOC 大概是 4.10 以上吧，所以实际上当然 Red Hat 的吧是它会 backport 很多 feature 回来，所以它 Red Hat 的版本号不是很靠谱。然后总之的话就是目前的说CentOS 的这个或者 RH 的这个最新的机械 RH 最新的这个 7里边最新的应该是没问题的。然后 Ubuntu 的这个已经把我们加到它的那个什么里面了，已经加到 distro 的支持里面了，也是没问题的。然后 SUSE 应该也是支持的，最新的版本应该都是支持的。
那现在就是 CPU 内容缓存隔离现在有没有支持啊？
这个问题啊，这是一个很怎么说呢，就是说目前来说的话，就是以现在 Intel CPU 的这个情况，就是你有人在，就是你很难做到，就是防止所有的未知的 side channel 的攻击。然后有一些 side channel 实际上是本身对虚机无效的，但有一些呢实际上不光对虚机，就算你 SGX 都是有效的。所以呢有的时候你去不得不在调度上面做一些手段去避免这种高危的不同用户去放到同一个 CPU 上面，这个就是共享开始的 CPU 上面，这个没办法，这个事情目前的说就是比如说像我们就很 care security 这个问题，那我们就直接把 HT 关掉了，都没办法。然后未来的 CPU 这事儿可能要看未来了。我觉得后面可以就私下下面的时候就可以吧。
不好意思，我们要准备下一场会议。